Hey folks, my name is Nathan Johnson and I have a geometry question for you today. If I put three non-overlapping circles inside an equilateral triangle, what is the largest amount of area that I can cover? Let's get into it. Okay, so let's be a little bit more precise. I'm going to draw an equilateral triangle that has side length 1. It doesn't have to have side length 1, but it's going to be convenient for us to pick a particular scaling. So let's go with side length 1. And I want to fit three circles in it. They're not allowed to overlap each other, and they're not allowed to stick outside of the triangle at all. I want the area contained within these three circles to be as large as possible. Okay, so what arrangement of three circles does this? So let's make a couple observations. First off, the circles, they can't have any wiggle room around them, okay? You cannot have a circle that has empty space all the way around it, because then you could just increase the radius of that circle to get a better configuration of circles, right? Okay, so the circles, they all have to be rigid in some sense. You can't have complete freedom to wiggle a circle around. Okay, but even with that constraint in mind, there's still lots of possibilities and still not immediately obvious what the best arrangement of circles is, okay? And I find a lot of people, they think that the best solution is this one right here, okay? This arrangement where you do three circles all of equal size, sort of tucked away, one in each corner of the triangle, all mutually tangent to each other. This was the arrangement of circles that I thought was probably optimal when I first heard about this problem, and I've surveyed a total of three people, and they all guessed the exact same configuration of circles as well, actually. And it turns out this is not optimal, though. So let's talk a little bit about why it's not optimal and how you can do better. Okay, so let's check how well this configuration here does. Okay, the area of the triangle, it's exactly root 3 over 4, or approximately 0.433. I'm going to work with decimals from here, approximations, just because we're going to be comparing the sizes of a whole bunch of different numbers. They all have exact forms, but they're kind of ugly and hard to compare without going to decimal approximations. So the area of the triangle is about 0.433. The area of those three equally sized circles all taken together is about 0.316, which is about 72.9% of the area of the triangle, okay? So that's how much of the triangle is covered, about 72.9%. And at first, this seems really good. This seems like, yeah, maybe it's optimal, because if you wiggle things around a little bit, in other words, if you make one of the circles a little bit larger at the expense of making the other circles a little bit smaller, you'll notice that the area covered goes down, okay? So it really does seem like this equally sized circle configuration is the best that we can do. Okay, but if you take this idea and run with it, if you make the top circle larger at the expense of making the bottom two circles smaller, yeah, at first, the area covered is going to go down a little bit, but then something happens when the first circle, the top one, gets big enough, then the area covered starts to sweep back up, okay? And if you go all the way to the most extreme configuration that you possibly could, where the first circle, the top one, is as large as possible while still being inside the triangle, and the other two circles are just, you know, filling in the corners a little bit, then it turns out the area covered, it's a teeny, teeny, tiny little bit larger than what we had when we used three equally sized circles, okay? This time the area covered, it's about 0.320 instead of 0.316, okay? We've got sort of that small of an improvement, about 0.004 extra units of area covered. The percentage of the triangle that's covered now, it's increased from 72.9% to 73.9%, okay? That much of an improvement. And it turns out this configuration actually is optimal. Okay, so let's talk about this optimal configuration of circles here. This one that has a large circle and then two smaller circles beside it. This configuration is what we call greedy, okay? Because one way you can think about it is when we want to place three circles inside this triangle as large as possible, well, just place them one at a time, okay? Just place the first circle as large as you possibly can inside the triangle without extending outside, and then place the second one as large as you can inside the leftover space without extending outside and without overlapping the first one that you're already placed, and then place the third circle as large as possible without overlapping either of the previous two and without extending outside the triangle. Okay, so you just sort of greedily place each one as large as possible as you can with the space that you have at that point. Okay, and it turns out this greedy method here, it gives you the right answer no matter what triangle you're trying to do this with. It's not specific to equilateral triangles, okay? So you can have a triangle that's isosceles or just, you know, any old scaling ugly triangle. It's still going to work. You just place your first circle as large as you can within inside that triangle, then place your second circle as large as you can with the leftover space, and then third circle as large as you can with that leftover space, and you're always, always, always going to get the maximum amount of area covered by three circles inside that triangle. Now, this problem is really interesting to me because it sounds like the type of problem that's so basic and so elementary that we should have solved it hundreds of years ago. And actually, we thought that we had solved it hundreds of years ago. In 1803, a mathematician named Malfatti, he wrote a paper where he claimed that if you want to solve this problem, okay, so three circles of maximal area inside a triangle, any triangle, not necessarily equilateral, what you do is you place three circles inside it that are all tangent to each other, okay? So in our case, for the equilateral triangle, that means those three equal-sized circles in the corners of the triangle that we saw at the start, that we conjectured were optimal but turned out not to be. Okay, he claimed that these were optimal, and this belief actually held for over 125 years. It wasn't until 1930 when Loeb and Richmond showed that, no, actually, like, the greedy solution does better, okay? It still wasn't known that the greedy solution was optimal, though, okay? So we still didn't have a solution to this problem. Then finally, 30 years ago in 1994, Zalgaller and Loos, they wrote a paper where they solved this problem and showed that yes, this greedy algorithm actually is optimal regardless of what your triangle is, okay? If you have three circles, you want to put in a triangle, you want them to cover the largest area possible, greedy algorithm is what you do. But we didn't know this until just 30 years ago. And the really interesting thing is that, okay, yes, this always gives you the optimal configuration if you've got three circles. It's not too hard to show, actually, that it always gives you the optimal configuration also if you only want to put one or two circles inside the triangle, okay? But the weird thing is we don't know whether or not this always gives you the optimal configuration when there are four or more circles. Even for just four circles, if you have the question of, okay, I want to put four circles inside this triangle and I want them to cover as much area as possible, what's the best way to do it? Unfortunately, the answer right now is we don't know. We think that the best way to do this is just to place them greedily, okay? First circle as big as possible, then second as big as possible, and so on down the line. And we think that this is optimal no matter how many circles you have, but we actually don't even know this for sure, even with just four circles inside a triangle. All right, that's all I've got for you today. Thanks for watching, everyone. Down in the description, I've got a bunch of extra links if you want to do some extra reading on this topic. Otherwise, I'll see you all next week.